Friday's on the Fisk. I'm very excited to have all of you here. So without further ado, let's begin.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and good evening, and welcome to all. I'm delighted that you are all here at Emmanuel Episcopal Church this evening as we inaugurate this organ through a dedicatory pipe organ festival. It seems like we've been blessing and dedicating this organ all spring, but why not celebrate when there's something to celebrate? So it's wonderful to have you all here as part of this celebration. I decided to open our recital this evening with the piece by Buxtehude for two reasons. One, nobody else on this series was playing any Buxtehude, so I decided that would be good. There's lots of Bach that will be coming this summer. But also that this piece really gets to demonstrate the independent pedal division of this organ. You could see that my feet were flying along there, the particular movement with the shimble stand, the little bells that you heard going. I use those there, that's not really typical, but there was nowhere else to use them, and I wanted you to at least hear them. So that sounded like a good place, and kept my mind off of the pedaling, so that was a good thing. But what it demonstrates is that independent pedal division that this organ has, and we're so lucky to have, with its trombone and its trumpet and its principal chorus, something that wasn't part of the initial contract of the organ, but made possible by the gifts from 15 families, visionary families, who came to make it a reality. Everything that you will hear on the program tonight utilizes that independent pedal. So let's be thankful for those who more or less gave in anonymity for that gift and that sacrifice. The next piece that I'm going to be playing is the chorale in E major by César Franck. César Franck, at the very end of his life, composed three chorales, Bach and Brahms. They all took the opportunity to kind of make a musical testament, so to speak. And that is what Franck did with the composition of his three chorales. They are not chorales in the kind of hymn tune fashion that you might think of the term chorale. They're more of a fantasy, and the chorale kind of unveils itself in that way. This gives me an opportunity to showcase the Frenchier sounds on the organ, things that are inspired by the Parisian builder Aristide Cavaillé-Cole. So I'm excited about that. It also, as a musical testament of the end of Franck's life, lets me tie into the people who gave gifts to this entire project in loving memory of those that they cherished and are no longer with us in this earthly place, at least. Anyhow, it's an appreciation for that. The Franck First Chorale.
Thank you.
incredible music and wonderful to get to make it here with you. The next piece I'm going to play for you is the Andante Sostenuto by Charles-Marie Vidor. The Andante Sostenuto comes from an organ symphony that is just a movement from there that features primarily the harmonic flute. It was a beautiful color stop that was designed and made possible and real by the French Parisian builder Cavaille Cole. And we had prepared for this stop when, and so it wasn't going to be included in this initial build, when I received a phone call on a Sunday afternoon. I was actually making the bed. And it was some parishioners who said, you know, we've had some very good fortune in the stock market this year. We would like to do something special. And that, combined with two other anonymous gifts, made the edition, last minute edition, of the harmonic flute a reality. So this is a piece that demonstrates what is possible when you have such beautiful things. We use it a lot here on Sunday morning in church. It's a wonderful stop that has an incredible blending quality about it. It's a wonderful solo stop, and I hope you will enjoy the Andante Sostenuto.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. A little backstory on that. When we closed out the Wicks organ, which used to live back there, the former pipe organ, we did a program with the three organists, I guess you could say, who had served here over the past like 30 years. And Johnny Bramburn, who I think is here somewhere, I think he's up there, there he is. He's in the balcony, he's pretending the Wicks is up there. Nothing like a comfortable place. Performed that in that closing concert. I can assure you that his playing was flawless, but the sound was not nearly as lovely. So it's wonderful to get to do that. The next piece that I'm going to play is by a German romantic composer by the name of Joseph Rheinberger. Rheinberger wrote a lot of music for the organ, and some of his music, although it's really great, has been kind of lost to time, which is too bad. But this comes from his 8th sonata. This is a Passacaglia. And I'm using this piece and then the closing piece on the recital to really demonstrate all of the different colors of the organ, all the different sounds that it can make, which makes it so different from the piano, for example. And we have a gorgeous piano here, where you've got this wonderful dynamic control, but you get that piano sound all the time. Here with the organ, you're kind of like a chef, and you put in the different ingredients, and you do the different things, and you get these different sounds that come from it, and different combinations. So this Rheinberger Passacaglia is going to do that for you from the very loudest to the very quietest stop on the organ and then back to loud and exciting again. So thank you very much. Actually, I'm gonna walk down here. I see my recorder. This is kind of tacky, beeping at me. So I just wonder if I failed to hit the start button. I just wanna make sure. This is going, I know for sure, but this is blinking at me.
Feedback right in here too, like a
sweet.
It's a hearing aid.
Oh, okay. I turned it on. There we go. This is casual. We're all friends. I think I know all of you, most of you, or now we're friends. Anyway.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's a wonderful piece. So now you've heard the organ in E minor, and you've heard it in E major. So it does play other keys. So the next two pieces, and I've got a violinist out here somewhere. I don't know where she is. Oh, there she is. Come on. are really, really special. And I'm very, very excited about this, these two pieces for two reasons. A little over a year ago, I was introduced to a gentleman named Graham Farrell, who happens to be a cousin of Margaret Farrell Page. And that's the connection, who is an organist, choir master, a pianist, a fabulous jazz player. And he introduced himself to me here about a year ago, and I didn't know anything of him. I thought, my goodness. And he tells me, well, I was baptized in this church in 1941. What? And so it was wonderful to get to meet him. And in that conversation, he told me about these two pieces, which he had just written for the 10th anniversary of the C.B. Fisk organ at Furman University. For organ and violin. And I said, well, I have a violinist. Can you send me the music? Sure enough. And that began a wonderful friendship and a wonderful connection. He has exchanged some wonderful music with me. I'm excited about some of the choral anthems that we'll get to use with the choir here in the coming season. So anyhow, it's a wonderful jazz idiom and compositional skill that he has on two hymn tunes, Bradbury, Savior Like a Shepherd Lead Us. It's hauntingly beautiful with this kind of jazzy counter melody that's a little punctuated, I guess you could say. And then the second one is on the hymn tune Solid Rock. So for the Baptists in the crowd, you'll really enjoy it. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing. And so two pieces, duets as he puts them, a duet between organ and violin.
Thank you. what a rich experience this is, coming back to this place after I was baptized here 75 years ago, and just before World War II, so that gives you some perspective. I have deep, deep roots here. But also, members of my family, my dear sister Jane was organist here when she studied with Mrs. Hodgkins, who was the mother of Norris Hodgkins. Then she studied with Mrs. Eakins. And then I came along as organist here under Martin Caldwell when I was in college. And then I came back in the early 80s when Nick White was here. So I keep bouncing back and forth from up north to Southern Pines. And I'm just so delighted to have these people so dedicated to my music. It just seemed to have lit a spark in these two people. And you're very lucky to have them here, I'll tell you.
Thank you so much, Graham, for being here. It is such a delight. You came down from New York just for this occasion. And so thank you for being here. And thank you for the gift of your music and that we can make it here in this place where the Holy Spirit descended upon you. Well, we have come to the end. Well, there's one more piece. And this is a wonderful, actually more recent work from 2007. That was commissioned by Dr. Faith Freeze. Faith Freeze is the professor of organ at the University of Alabama, Roll Tide, which is where my wife Amanda, that's her alma mater, and we cheer for them. But that wasn't really the connection. I heard her play this in Recital when it was newly commissioned and just absolutely fell in love with it. It is a colorful, varied piece and really shows off the organ in some really cool and neat ways. It's based off of a theme from a Danish kind of popular song. The translation is, "Will You Dance With Me?" So there's also a connection, the title of this piece, "To Call My True Love to the Dance." For those of you who might know sacred music more, "Tomorrow Shall Be My Dancing Day." That text and tune is kind of the inspiration for that. So I look forward to sharing this with you. Just a few quick notes. I just want to say thank you again for being here, being in attendance. There is a reception in the Parish Hall foyer afterwards. If you'd like to come and have a little nibble and chit-chat and be in fellowship together, that would be great. If you don't know your way, it's through this door right here. Make a left and make a right, go up some stairs. That sounds confusing, so just follow somebody who knows what they're doing. Two, you'll see in your program booklets that there is a whole lot of information in there. Statements from organ builders and acousticians and liturgical designers and everybody else involved, the rector, the senior warden. This organ is part of a major project, but it's not the only thing that happened. But this booklet tries to tell that story a little bit and how this parish and congregation came to make that a reality. You'll notice towards the back, there are 3 pages worth of donors. Some gave just for the organ, some gave just for the building, some gave just for debt, some gave just for outreach, but they all gave together to make it a reality. There is still opportunity to participate in helping pay for the things that we have done. And so you can write your checks, and in the bottom memo line, capital fund. All right, put that right there. The organ isn't finished. As you see on the very back cover, there are a number of things that say preparation. That means the mechanism is here, the stop knob is here, and all that sort of stuff, but it doesn't do anything. You know, those are wonderful opportunities for memorial gifts and estate things and all those sorts of things. If those are things that you're interested in, see me about it, chit chat. There are plates at the door that will help offset the cost of this concert series. And then there are 3 more recitals. The next one is July 19th, which is Dr. Andre Lash, the professor of organ at the University of North Carolina at Greensboro. Then the one that follows that is August 5th by Chase Loomer, who is the winner of last year's Southeast Regional Competition for Young Organists. He'll be a junior at the Eastman School of Music. Very fine player. He grew up in Charlotte, and so I'm excited about that. And then the series will conclude on August 19th with a recital by my wonderful colleague across town, Stephen Gorley. Stephen's here, actually, with his parents. So it's one of you can wave, Stephen. Some people know you. he'll conclude the program for us. He's the organist choir master at the Village Chapel. And it will be wonderful to have him here. He's a wonderful colleague to have in town. And finally, I just want to say thank you to my organ student, Michael, who has been a wonderful page turner. It's not an easy job. It's a stressful job. And he has just been fantastic. So thank you, and thank you all for being here.